presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hey, Robert, how you doing, man?
Yes, and thank you for taking my call. I wanted to let you know that I've been a subscriber for a couple of years, just different members of your team, and I really enjoy it. But really the reason I'm calling is to express my sincerest gratitude for you providing that information yesterday on the small business grant. I'm a small business owner and primary breadwinner for my family, and if I can get that money, it's going to really mean a lot to my family. So
that's awesome.
Thank you for taking the time to do that.
No, well, listen, man, we appreciate you growling a problem with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. You are what you believe you are. Humans are powerful magicians. You have the power to make yourself what you are right now, but it's not your reasoning mind that controls you. It's what you believe. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 87, NASDAQ up 51, S&P's up 15.5, gold contract up a buck, trading 1831 an ounce. You got silver up 45 cents, $26.85 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 89 cents, $55.65 a barrel. Notes and bonds. We get the 10-year right now down 4 ticks, trading 136.25. The 30 off 20 at 167.26 in King Dollar. King Dollar's down 29 ticks, trading 91.175. The Euro's at 120. The Yen is at 105.05. And the British Pound's at 136 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay, so what we have here, we're going to start actually going all the way back right into the December time frame, folks. So the first leg down that we had high volume on the way down, that was basically the middle of December. Market snaps right back, came back down again in the beginning of January. And then we came down last week two separate times, each time with an expansion of volume. Oops, let's get those charts up. Shame on me. Okay. Thank you, Tapoon. Let's get this. There we go. You're not going to. There we go. Okay. So when we came down, you know, so that what that sets up, folks, is it's four different times that you've come down with volume. And as we've gone back up, the first time when we went back up, actually the second time we went back up, the volume was pretty good. That was it. So the last time that we actually had volume in there brings you back to January 6th. That's how that sets up. Now, this one here, the bottom line, you had an expansion of volume on the way down. And since then, that contraction's pretty dramatic. Okay, the first day inside the SPY, you know, we went up on 75 million. Yesterday, you did 64 million, and we'll see what we get today. It's only 33 right now. So what's happening is that folks are basically shying away from buying up at this area. We go into the NDX 100. You got to remember something. The NDX brings the market up, brings the market down. The chip stocks do the same thing. And inside of the NDX. Now, this is what the difference is inside of the NASDAQ composite, I mean, NDX also. So the S&Ps, bottom line, came down hard four different times. The NASDAQ composite did not. NASDAQ 100. What it did do is that last week it came down hard twice. That being said, you are contracting in a pretty dramatic way coming up here, okay? We made a low out here, and we were banging out 55 million shares. First day up off it, you did 35 million shares. Yesterday, we did 33 million shares. Well, today, we have 19 million shares. So the bottom line here is that you coming into about 40 million share day, I think we're going to do about 20. What I do expect you're going to see, though, is that you're going to see that test of the highs. I mean, we're into Wednesday right now. You get Thursday and Friday in order to do it. And one of our tigers are telling us that we did test the high. Let me see that. That high is what, 599. Well, I have 13,599. We hit 13,584. Bottom line, I expect it's going to get tested. So, you know, we'll see how this shakes out the next couple of days. What that is saying to me, though, is that more than likely we're going to see you're going to get up to those highs. You're going to fail on price and volume. Now, what that means specifically is this, folks, is that you get over the high, you close under the high, and you have lighter volume. The cool thing about how we're setting up right now is this. It's very hard to get consistency. Number one, that we've gone down four times in the S&P with volume, and every time the volume accelerated on the way down. Now what has happened is that you're going up 4 days in a row, and you're having that contraction at the same time. So your probabilities go pretty cool at that level. We'll see where the whole thing shakes out. What you do want to do, and we're going to do this right now, I'm going to go over to the bond market next. And the reason we're going to go over the bond market is this, is that the 10-year has been teetering and staying in its higher range. Now, we're one tick below it today. It's 136.26. We're at 136.25. What I expect we will see is this. If, in fact, you're going to get a test of the high and you're going to get a failure, you're going to see prior to this, the next couple days, you're going to see buy-in start coming in the 10-year, as well as the 30. But the 10-year is the one you really, you want to keep your eye on. Because if that's what we get, that is going to be another indication that, guess what? There's a lot more larger players that are saying, okay, in the 30-year, see, this is intriguing with the 30-year. The 30-year is testing its lows of about a month ago also. You know, so if you get that, if you get buying that starts in there, you got some real action on the way down. Because once you do have a correction going, you'll see those notes and bonds go very fast on the way up. If we go over to the TLT and we take a look at the 20-year, this is interesting because the 20-year broke its low. Yeah, so this is 149.92, and we hit, okay, so it's rejected it. Oh, this is, so check this out, man. 149.92 is the last low. You did 12 million shares. You're only doing 6 million today. Bottom line, that's saying that you're getting a small rejection of price. So I think this is game on, and, we'll see where this shakes out. The next couple of days. But that's telling me that, guess what? This baby wants to pull back. Dow Industrials. Dow right now up 82. Nasdaq's up 44. S&P's up 15. And good old King Dollar. King Dollar basically down 22 ticks at 91.169. Come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now are up 76. You get the Nasdaq up 32. S&Ps are up 13. And we'll just check in with GameStop. GameStop right now, folks, $95.36. And what I expect you're going to see here, this thing's going to make its way down to this $20 level once again. It makes sense it has some kind of support here because you'll probably get another bounce before we actually get down there. But that thing is done. What's going to be intriguing here is that let's go to AMX first. AMC. So you get the AMC, yeah, that's trading 97 cents up. This thing's going to go all the way back to probably $3. What you did have out here today is that you had the the SEC. Let's see what they have to say. This is too funny, man. So the SEC, Security and Exchange investigators are combing social media and message boards for signs of fraud that played a role in the stock swings of GameStop and AMC holdings, as well as other companies. The bottom line, folks, is that the SEC can look all they want. What I suspect they're going to basically be looking for is not so much the traders that are on Reddit. They would be looking for a couple large funds that were in there goosing it, basically doing the real squeeze. We'll see where that whole thing shakes out. But when you have an equity that was 140% short position, I mean, okay, who's kidding who? The thing that is amazing is that it didn't happen before this. that's the real amazing part, actually. And it's intriguing that the rest of Wall Street could sit there. Anyone could have run that stock with any amount of money. Okay. But the bottom line is that with good money, yeah, you could run that stock in a second. NVAX. So I believe this one, this the baby ran pretty good yesterday. So this is, I believe that they also coming out with the COVID vaccine, a digital biotech company. Low for the year is, look at this, oh my God. The low for the year is $6.26. The high is $2.97. And yeah, look at this, man. Oh, my God. Okay, so I guess if the question, let's see. Okay, so This trader has free shares. Okay, so let's bring this back. So he's already got his money back. Oh, I see what's happening. Okay. Well, we got an ABC up. Let's see where it brings us. Okay, so you got... That's 186. My God, that's 16. It's like $175. Oh, interesting, though. That's 250. I'd move it, man. This just finished an ABC structure up. And it did it in 2 weeks. You know, so you got to figure out, what do you want to do? But that bottom line is that when they finish ABC structures up, it does not mean that the stock basically just turns immediately. In this case, you can look at the numbers. The numbers are pretty astronomical here. This year they expect to do $497 million, and most of that was in last quarter and this quarter coming. But then next year they plan on doing $3.2 billion. But I can tell you that when ABC's, and that's a one-to-one ABC structure on the way up. Most times when you have that, the bottom line, you got to get a retracement. And if you get a retracement on this, there's no reason that it can't fill the gaps. That's what that comes down to. What will be intriguing, one of the tigers in the den is saying, my grandson is bond at the market top. Now, this would be really wild, folks, if that's the case, because the reason, listen to this, this is crazy. There's a history of this going all the way back, not only tops and bottoms, my father's birthday, my son's birthday. It's like really crazy, man. That's how I remember some of these tops and bottoms in a big way. So that would be really a mind blower if that's the case. And we'll find out. because even in the year 2000, if you remember what happened, we had one top in January, the next one was in March, and both of those bottom line had to do with inside of my family, which is really crazy. I mean, right to the day too, we're talking. So that was like bizarre. And then anyway, that'd be something else, man. Let's go take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here. And you got, let's see. So Tilray's up 272. That's moving. You got U.S. Steel. We're going to look at that. That's down $1.30. Eastman Kodak, oh man, that's on the move again, unreal. That's up $1.46. That's trading $10. You get Bank of America down up 59 cents. Let's go look at the banks, because if the market's gonna basically do a pullback, you're gonna see the banks pull back also, and particularly because if we have the interest rates go down versus going up, there's another reason to sell them. So yeah, J.P. Morgan up $1.75 today. Another contraction of volume, no doubt. That doesn't say that you're going to pull back dramatically, though. Bank of America, same deal. That's up 59 cents. Let's go over to U.S. Steel and take a look at the commodity markets there. Oh, interesting. What happened here? This gap down with volume. This is pretty intense. Someone move this out. Yeah, U.S. Steel looks like it's going to get into this $14.32 area anyway. So let's go iron ore. I'm going to pull up iron ore, because iron ore is one of the first ones that really start taking off, folks, months ago. Yeah, I think that's... So we had hit $12.47 a ton. You're at $9.52. You started out in the 200s. It came back to its sign of strength. We'll see where that shakes out. Let me go to Valley. That's one of the biggest. Okay, so Valley. Okay, this is pretty good. Valley's saying iron ore wants to go higher. Now, this didn't hold price up here today at 1730, but you get big volume coming in. And you have a high volume high that has a volume up at the high. We go take a look at Mosaic. Mosaic came down last week. Yeah, but Mosaic wants its high again, too. That's how that's shaken up. Mosaic came back to a sign of strength. We, 9 million. Yeah, you came back with 6 million versus 9 million. That's saying they still want higher price, you know? It's going to be about this dollar, folks. We'll see where this whole thing shakes out. But the dollar inside the commodities is the deal. And oil wants 60 bucks, man. Stay right there, folks. Coming right back. Dow Industrials up 94. NASDAQ up 28. S&P's up 13.5. We'll come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hanks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market. Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour. Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m. Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m. And Tom O'Brien closes out the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now up 73. You get the NASDAQ up 12. S&Ps are up 10. And Amazon, folks, bottom line, Amazon came in with big numbers last night. It's down 52 bucks. They're going to have a new CEO. And, you know, the stock took it really well. That's the real bottom line, is that. And what's interesting here, when I was looking at this, we'll bring up the board and the management so you can see how this kind of lays out. Because it almost looks like that. First, I'm going to look at the executives. It almost looks like Bezos basically was kind of the chairman of the board anyway. Because what you're going to see here is that the guy that is going to be and the CEO, he was the CEO of Web Services. Then they have a CEO, Dave Clark, of Worldwide Consumer Products. And then they have two, basically, you know, they have a CFO and a comptroller, which you need. So you get too many people there. You get your general counsel, and he had these two other CEOs, you know. So the bottom line is kind of when you look at that, it's like, okay, Bezos more than likely was acting as a chairman of the board, you know, for some time. That's the way it seems to be set up. He had both titles, and now, of course, he's just going to do the title of chairman of the board. And, you know, we'll see how this shakes out in the future. But the bottom line is that he definitely has the confidence, the new CEO has the confidence of Bezos in a huge way. There's no doubt about that. And what's intriguing is that the new CEO that's coming in, he put some weight behind Amazon Games today. Okay, the bottom line is that one of the first things he said is that we are going to get these Amazon Games going. And they've had a tough time getting Amazon Games going, period. So we'll see where this whole shakes out. But, you know, you could it totally makes sense. I mean, the guy was there 25 years. He made it left and right. Now the real bottom line is that does he want to do the space program? Where's it going to go? I think it's going to be just like the aspect of Bill Gates. He'll get involved in something. Gates definitely is. Bezos hasn't shown the amount of giving away money as Gates has. I can tell you that, and we'll see if that changes. It may not change. But, you know, we'll see where that shakes out. The if we go take a look at the small caps. So the small caps out here right now, the IWM, this also has a contraction of volume. This one's going to be tricky, the small caps, because what you have inside here is that when we came down last week twice, what we had done is gone into the breakout area, and you actually had a contraction of volume instead of an expansion of volume. You know, so as you're looking at the market, I suspect what is going to happen is this, is that it's going to be the SPY and the S&P that's actually going to give it up first, because the S&P has the most consistency of price and volume, meaning that we've gone down four times on volume, you pull back up, contraction in a big way. The NDX 100 went down twice, came back, okay, instead of four times. And then the IWM, that is the only one that actually, when it came down, that contraction, it was a contraction of volume when you came down, versus the other ones was not a contraction of volume. Let's get over and we take a look at the XAU, the HUI. Well, let's go look at silver first, because this silver deal's not over, folks. We go take a look at the silver market here. The silver market, this baby is up 36 cents today. No big deal, 40 cents. But what silver did, you know, silver basically came back to where it broke topside from. You know, I expect, you know, you'll build cars there for a bit. But the SLV is still in an ABC structure on the way up. And let's see. We put this on the structure. Okay, so now it's going to be a complex ABC structure on the way up. So this is what a complex ABC structure is, folks, is that you get over the B point. In this particular case, the B point was $27.35. You get over it with volume, and then you give it up on price. So what you have here is this, is that I'll go through this right now. Okay, let's do this. This is cool. I like going through these complex ones, because what does happen is this, is that let's put this, I'll go that way, we'll line this up so you can see this whole baby. Okay, so the bottom line, it's a very large ABC structure. Your A point gets you all the way back to where we started from, coming off the lows in March. Your B point is the highs that were generated out here in August. Your C point is the downdraft that was created out here on the week of the 25th. So what you do is this, okay, you got over the highs, you had volume over the highs. That's where your ABC structure is. The complex part of it goes like this, is that as you are pulling back, as long as you pull back with light volume into the strength, that would still be considered an ABC structure on the way up. If we get an expansion of volume, however, that changes the whole scenario. Thus far, we haven't got an expansion of volume. Thus far, what you have is this. You get the SLVs making highs with 290 million shares. You pull back with 126 million shares. You're going sideways out here with 47 million shares. So I suspect that higher prices are coming at us. Let's go to Tim in Denver, Colorado. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hello, Tom. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Okay, good. Thanks. Good. Congratulations to Tommy and you also.
Thank you so much. I know. We're so psyched.
It's a great thing.
I'm getting the pictures every day.
All right. Well, good.
Okay.
I bought a stock the other day and an option on it. And I'm wondering if it was, it could work out pretty well, I thought. So, in any case, the stock is FUBO, Fubo.
Okay. Yep.
And I bought it at $50.17.
Yeah.
And I bought the May 21st $50 calls, and they were
$17.75. Ooh. Wow. You paid some money for those. Okay, so let me just get this straight. So you
I sold some. I sold them.
Oh, you sold them.
Right. Sold the calls.
Oh, thank God. You're in heaven. Okay, cool, man. So bottom line is that you bought the stock. You basically sold the call, right?
Right. Yep.
That's a great... Now you're talking, man. So when I first said, oh, my God, folks, okay, it's the premium that was paid there. That was a 33% premium. Now, the differential is that Tim's taking the premium in, and that's totally where it's at, man. You get May. I think you're in good shape, man. As long you want to own the stock anyway, right?
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, I mean, if it sells, let me just wait. If I get called at $50, I still made $1,700.
That's great. No, I know that. I'm with you there. Just stay right there, okay? Come right back.
Okay, sure.
Okay.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrial is up 91, Nasdaq's up 35, S&Ps are up 13. We're talking with Tim, and we are talking about FUBO, Fubo TV. So the reason that I asked you that do you want to own the stock is that when you do a buy right, which you're doing, right?
Right.
Is that you got to be prepared that, you know, the stock's not going to be over 50. And this stock looks to me like it's going to pull back to somewhere around 40, you know?
Right. No, I was kind of thinking the same thing, but I'd still be, you know, have made some money on those.
Oh, it's huge. Yeah. Because what ends up happening there, folks, even though he bought it at 50, if it's at 40, he's still making $7 by May 21st. Yeah. No, I think it's a good strategy, man. And let me just see something else, because a couple of targets in the den tell me they're running it. Oh, so this is going to get interesting. So the other side of that, this is one of the ones they like to run, folks. The bottom line is that you get a 40% short position. Yeah, you're in good shape, man. I think that's a great trade, man.
Okay.
There's not many times that you're going to get a 33% of the stock value as a premium, man. And you're not.
Right, and I didn't think so. And, of course, if it does go down, my break-even is like 32.50, so at that point I have to do something else. But
that's right. But guess what? In this environment, I think that is a high probability trade that you're going to do very well on. You know, when you're sticking out there, folks, with a 40% short position, you have a sign on your front and on your back, bottom line, saying, hey, look at me, 40% short position. You know, because what you're going to have here, there's going to be even more pros that are paying attention to the aspect of how high are these short positions? And, you know, can we basically run them out of the market? So I think you're in pretty good shape, man.
Okay, good. And the other thing I wanted to ask you, Tom, was, you know, the price of oil and energy, I guess, my guess is it's going to be going up. And wondering what that's going to do to the gold miners. I mean, obviously it's going to be a drag.
Oh, that's a great question. That's a great statement, actually. Yeah, so what happens is this. So let's go take a look at this. So my take is that, yes, that oil does want to go up to the $60 level. And what Tim's talking about is that energy, folks, is one of the highest expenses that miners have. You know, so, you know, at $60, does that kill it? No, it doesn't kill it, but it will make a difference. I mean, you know, it's been traded at 60 for a long time. I mean, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
There's no doubt. But then what does happen here, let me show you something here, NGD. If you're in that market, folks, what you want to start looking for is you're going to start looking for folks that don't use as much oil inside it. Now, this equity here, I wouldn't be buying this right yet, but this is going to be a cool little equity. This is New Gold, and what New Gold has going for it, that company, they have one of the biggest hydropowers. They're not paying for hardly anything. So that's kind of the route that you want to start taking if, in fact, not so much at 60. It'd be over 60. The real thing I think that's going to drive the metals market in particular is that we have to see what happens when the dollar basically, you know, I suspect first looks like it wants to go to 92. You know, is that dollar going to fall apart? You know,
oh, right.
And, you know, we'll see. I mean, the bottom line is that we know that money keeps getting out there. I mean, it looks like the stimulus bill is going to come through. It's going to take probably another 6 weeks, folks, but there's going to be $1.9 billion, you know. No, but is it? No, it's more than that, right? Is it?
Yes. Well, I heard that number, but who knows what it's really going to be.
Is it billion or trillion? Hold it.
1.9 trillion.
Yeah. You know, that's going to be coming at us. I mean, they're arguing right now about the aspect of the $1,400 stimulus. But I suspect what's going to happen there is that they'll bring the amount of money that people can make. Right now, I think it's 75 and 150. They'll probably bring it down to 50 and 100 or something. Do you know what I mean? 50 for a single, 100 for a married couple, which totally makes sense. I mean, right. You know, in that aspect. But it'll be intriguing to see what the rest of that money goes for, you know. But it's going
to
be
exactly, because I think that the money that's going to the people is going to be a very small amount, and the majority of it goes to special interest.
This is going to get really interesting, exactly, as to where does it go, because you got to remember something, folks. In 2008, the money went to all the banks, okay? And the bottom line is that, you know, everyone can be flipped out, and they should be flipped out because they bailed them out, and, you know, the bottom line is that the banks made a fortune on it, paid out all the dividends, still making a fortune on it. The first two of these stimuluses here, I'd say, got spread kind of evenly, okay? But as to this one, you know, we'll find out where the rest of that money's going to go, because I don't think they've really pushed as to where it's going to go. If it's going to bureaucracies, I'd say it's going to be a problem. Not necessarily bureaucracies that are actually cities. And the reason I'm saying that is that what I've seen in like St. Petersburg and Tampa, just that's where we live, is that when they, in the CARES Act, folks, what they had is this. So they had the PPP program, then they had the SBA program. And then what they had done is this, is that they had giving the cities or the counties, it was the counties, I believe, okay, in Florida. They gave them a good amount of money to give to small businesses. And where we are in Pinellas County, they did a very good job of that. You know, and not for someone like TFNN, but for people that, you know, really needed it, meaning all those small stores on the boardwalks, you know, they gave them two different rounds of $5,000 apiece to stay in business. So if they have more of that, I think that's going to be very helpful for Main Street. Do you know what I'm saying? That the people that have worked their butt off, and, you know, if you have no business, you have no business. So we'll see where it shakes out. But to cut to the chase, I think inflation's out here, man. There's a lot of money coming in. So cooking, brother.
Okay, thanks, Tom.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Let's go take a look at this S&P. S&P, bring up these futures right now. It's always intriguing, folks, when you're just getting at highs. This is not ready just yet. You know, when you're so close, you know what the hard thing is? The hard thing is when you get so close to the highs and you don't hit them, that on a real test, you just love hitting them. Even I think we hit the bottoms bars of the highs. It's close. My take is that I'm still going to wait it out another 48 hours. Because what does happen, folks, is that if, in fact, you got into there with gusto, you could take a leg up. The cool thing about setting a trade up at highs or lows is that you do not have to give it a lot of juice. You have to give it something, because if I'm correct in the aspect that we are going to have a correction, what normally would happen is this, is that you get to the high. Now, the day that you get to the high, intraday, there'll be some kind of a spike. What big operators try to do is that they're going to spike the high. They try to see, are there more orders, buy orders up there? If there's no buy orders up there, then it's see ya, don't want to be ya. You know, that's kind of how most of the bigger corrections actually really get going. And if a good correction gets going, folks, the bottom line, be fast with your fingers, because, you know, we've gone up so dramatically that we could have a decent correction. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Back back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by,
bam!
As well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 65, Nasdaq's up 18, S&P's are up 9. Let's go to Bill in Boston. Hey, Bill, what's going on, brother?
Tom, I was hoping you could look at Canopy Growth for me. I've owned it for a while. It's had a hell of a month. And I just think it's getting a little topped out.
So you have Canopy, folks, which has been on the tear. The low's $9, the high's 45. So it's just finished an ABC structure on the way up. That being said, man, if you've owned it for a while, man, I would stay right there. You can take some grief, but this has a high volume high, man. I mean, if you're buying this for a longer time, I mean, that high volume high is sticking out like a sore thumb, man, at 66. So,
yeah, that was my thought, because I do believe in the cannabis story for a while, especially with the pets and Martha Stewart.
I mean, let me tell you something, okay? This is just like prohibition, folks. The bottom line, pot's going to be legal, and these companies are going to be scrambling for it. And Canopy Growth, I think that's one of the best ones just because Constellation, runs it. So Constellation is one of the biggest booze companies. And, yeah, I would stay right there, man. It's not going to go straight up like it has, okay? But it's on the road, man. They're all on the road. These states need taxes, okay? we know the hypocrisy out here in general, folks, in states in general. The bottom line is that they need taxes. And guess what? That's going to be one of the easiest ones to get taxes, man. Just tax the heck out of it.
That's a great angle. Thanks,
Tom. Cooking, brother. Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. And the tax structure, well, actually, New York right now, they're trying to get taxes on transactions again. Okay, this is going to be a huge deal. I think it'll get shot down once again. Every stock we trade, they want to get a tax on. They're freaking dreaming, folks. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being there, folks. Have a great one. Have a safe one. Come back and visit us tomorrow. Please tell your friends about TFNN. Tell them to go to YouTube, search TFNN, and subscribe. Have a great one. Have a safe one.